Well, after a short break, due to largely me being stupid and forgetting my microphone for a while, we are back and ready to continue with Doctor Who Series 8. This is Episode 9, Flatline. It's loading now, and it is up, so I'm putting subtitles on, because new iTunes, you can do that now. And you know the drill. Now, a bearded man. I have no idea what's going on. I think I know this guy from somewhere. Oh, it's the parasites from Operation Annihilate. Classic Star Trek reference for the win. I have that phone. And I'm not even British. Well, if you put, like, a giant tapeworm thing on your wall, you're really just asking for this. And the awesome opening credits, as always. Counting up to 12 because there's 12 doctors. Took me an embarrassingly long time to get that. Jamie Mathiasen. I think I recognize that name from earlier in this season. Maybe he did some other earlier. Oh, that's going to be like a Chekhov's gun. I'm calling it right now. Me too. Well, Ish was good enough for Sarah Jane. Now, Moffat has said that he's not writing 12 any differently from 11, and it's all down to the performance. I believe it. What? What am I looking at? Ah, okay. Perspective screwed with me a bit. Is this like what happened to the meddling monk? Yeah, try it 8 more times. Maybe it'll work. That'd be cool. You're annoying. Yeah. I must have had a lot of fun with that prop. Well, it's not smaller on the inside at all. So that's weird. Are they going to reference the meddling monk? Because that would be cool. I know that guy. So this is the guy that's supposed to be nasty, even though they're criminals. So they gotta send him really over the top to convince us he's a bad guy. She's entered Broadchurch. He's Adagio. He's the nice criminal. Yeah, lean your face in when you say that. That'll get people on your side. Well, that'll happen. Yeah, kind of is. How do you know? He could be like the Doctor from Voyager in that one episode. Okay, he is the same size then. Yeah, probably. It's kind of an awkward green screen effect there. Makes sense. Okay, they, nice effect with the green screen there. Yeah, it sort of does. It's like getting Hawkeye's bow and arrow. Like Jakar. Yep. This could get me liking her. Yeah, this is something that Capaldi is much better at than, like, I think Matt Smith would have been. He's the curmudgeon. Hey, Elementary's back on. Much better than Sherlock. Oh yeah, I said it. Writing convenience. That's what I would say. Oh, daughter of mine. She's gonna run into the daughter of mine. I can hear you. Quite a few things, knowing you. Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, I would like this guy to stick around for a while. Probably. And you're just nothing. I really have no idea what's going on here. Hopefully this will turn out better than the last time that happened. Writing contrivance. I have never been able to keep British, like, intelligence services straight. This guy has no idea without a map. Oh, this should work out well. That state sentence has a double meaning. I got that one. Well, in your case, you know. This is very, I forget what it's called. It's, like, a student film by, like, the guy that made Tremors. It's about a, like, giant reel of film that sneaks under the carpet and swallows people. Pretty neat movie. Check it out if you can. It's on the Tremors 4 DVD as a special feature. Are we going back into E-Space? That's cool. Well, duh. This is like that one Star Trek Next Generation episode. You know, like Riker finds it, wakes up to find that his arm has been cut off and reattached. It was creepy. That's a neat effect. It's like something from a Joe Dante movie. And Danny calls. Called it. Why does he have an aerosol can? This sounds quite suggestive. Nothing, well, certainly nothing I need a soldier's help with. This is cool. Well, they can't have a digestive tract, they'd fall in half. Kind of is. Well, you can hear that well enough. I actually don't know that guy. I thought he was Michael Massey, actually. And you couldn't possibly have figured this out from that look you got earlier. I am a nasty guy, acting like a nasty guy because that's my job. It's kind of an Amelie thing going on here. This is a really good idea. Being executed well, I like it. Flatlanders? The Royal Flush Gang? That's a good one, if taken. Yeah, it has a really good external and internal conflict. That's always like the ideal thing I aim for. You got the external conflict of the two-dimensional things, internal of Claire trying to be the doctor. They both work really well off each other. Pretty much. Yeah, what is the difference between MI5 and MI6? I've never been able to figure that out. Probably. Yeah, that would be a good twist to this. That's the idea we're going with this week, anyway. The Unquiet Dead People. And the guys from the Curse of Fatal Death. Yeah, you covered that already. Yes, thank you. I think even Clara got that one. The Tribbles. And the Tribbles are back. And you're dead. Congrats. And you move, and he's done. Yep. I love those kinds of obstacle illusions. Yeah, you can do more damage in there. Now you're going to run into Pride from Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood. Yeah, I'm with the old guy on that one. Why even open your mouth? You've shattered the universe. Congratulations. Yeah, see, this is where that comet would have come in handy. And now he's not making it, of course. Well, that was a nice little plot cul-de-sac, wasn't it? Or a very obvious Chekhov gun. That was unexpected. And he goes into heaven or not? Yeah, we just needed a bit of padding. That's a nice effect. And congratulations, another minute of padding done. Yeah, that'll be a problem. Try the door, maybe? And now they're gonna try to build tension out of this, even though there's no way he's gonna die. That is a fake train there. I think they used up all their special effects budget on the, 3D people. I don't know what that means. Oh, right, they're sticking the hand out. A lot of friction he's getting off that thing. Not quite sure this warrants the big heroic music. Oh, I'm so sure he's dead. WND. Oh, W up D. That's less offensive. No, same one. Just as fake. Because there's people standing right there. Me too. Just put a lunchbox on it. How is he not moving yet? Guy's an idiot all of a sudden. No, that didn't work. It's the morphing cube from Animorphs. So that's what Loki wanted the whole time. Yeah, this is exactly the kind of thing Clara needs to like be a more engaging character. So, gotta kill someone. I imagine that took a few takes. Why does that always work? I don't know what she's doing, but I'm sure it'll work because it's almost the end of the episode. Yeah, she's not hearing a thing. Yeah, that's the drawing. He's just a judo master. Yeah, they haven't figured it out by now. Yeah, he did. But I'm not a soldier for some reason. Eleven did it better. You're really going to make that your last words. So more people who have to just cover this up now. That guy'll make a good actor. I'm a conservative straw man. Not really. My real name's Picasso. They're gonna do that, aren't they? Like, reveal he's someone famous. He's got, like, the future hat from Back to the Future, too. Almost got through a whole episode without mentioning it. Don't know what he meant by that. Suddenly, I want an iPad. Still not caring who you are, lady. This is like a Discworld thing now. Okay, no idea what's going on there, but looks interesting. Well, that was a really good one. Like I said, good internal and external conflict. Could have done without the straw man gang boss, but what are you gonna do? Sometimes those things just slip in. You have to deal with them. Season's back on track after a couple missteps. Last few have been very good, and I've heard good things. Like I really have gone out of my way to avoid spoilers, but people do really seem to like the rest of the season so far. Looking forward to that. See you there.